the chapter rectilinear figures. This comes under the section geometry, the rectilinear figure for class 9 standard students. We have already discussed how to solve the questions of exercise number 14A and 14B. Now in this video we are going to solve the questions of exercise 14C. Specifically for exercise 14C, before we start solving the problems, three very important points I want to discuss. First very important point is the basics. You should be absolutely clear with the basics of the rectilinear figures, that is the properties of parallelogram, rectangle, square, rhombus, kite, all of these quadrilaterals. You should be absolutely clear with them. If you are not clear with the basics, then you will face problems in exercise 14C. Another important point is figure. In some of the questions of this exercise, the figure is not given. Now wherever figure is given, it is easier, you can directly copy the figure. Wherever figure is not given, you must draw correct figure. You can very easily invite trouble for yourself by drawing wrong figures. I will show you examples as you are solving problems. In some problems they have not given the figure, and if you are drawing the wrong figure, then it is very very difficult. In fact, that is the easiest way to invite trouble for yourself. Then you cannot prove it. In that case, it will be very difficult and it will result only in time wastage. So you should draw proper figure. Wherever you have to draw figure, please do use your ruler, protractor and compass and draw a proper figure rather than drawing a figure with a free hand. Third important point is, there is no single correct way of solving such problems. In most of the questions, you have to prove. Now whenever a proof is required, there is no one correct way. You are free to prove in any way, provided you do not violate the basic properties. For example, you know that in a parallelogram, the diagonals are bisecting each other. But in a parallelogram, diagonals are not equal. So you are having a quadrilateral in which you are having diagonals which are equal. Then that is a special case of rectangle or square. Now you are having a quadrilateral in which diagonals are bisecting each other. It is a parallelogram. You cannot say that it is a rectangle or square till you prove that diagonals are equal to each other. So the properties, the basic properties of rectangle, square, rhombus, those basic properties you should not violate. That is the basic rule. In case you are following that rule, after that you are free to prove whatever is required in whatever manner you want to prove. So these three important points: basics, figure, and there is no one single correct way. That is very important for exercise 14C. So now let us start solving the question of exercise 14C. Question number 1 is, so this is the first question of exercise 14C. We have been given that ABCD is a parallelogram. So here I have drawn a figure. ABCD is a parallelogram. And then E and F are midpoints. That means DF is equal to FC. DF is equal to FC. And AE is equal to EB. AE is equal to EB. We have to prove that AEFD is a parallelogram. So before attempting this question, you should be knowing the basic properties of a parallelogram. For example, in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal, opposite sides are parallel, diagonals will bisect each other, and opposite angles are equal. So what we have to prove is that DF is parallel to AE, number 1, and then DF is equal to AE, number 2. So this you can easily say. For example, you know that ABCD is a parallelogram. That means CD is equal to AB. This means that 1 half CD is equal to 1 half AB. So this means that DF is equal to AE. So this is one point. Another is that you can say that CD is parallel to AB. And this is a straight line. This means that DF is also parallel to AE. So this is one set. of conclusion. So this I am writing here what we have concluded, that DF is equal to AE and DF is parallel to AE. So this is the first set of conclusion. Let us join D and E. Let us look at triangle DFE and triangle EAD. That is this and this triangle. You can see that angle FDE is equal to angle AED because it is alternate angle. So you can say that angle FDE is equal to angle AED. These are alternate interior angles. Then you can say that this ED is equal to ED, a common side, and you can also say that AE is equal to DF. So you can say that DF is equal to AE. That means by SAS, you can say that these two triangles are congruent. This means you can say that corresponding part of congruent triangles. So this, and you can also say that angle DFE, this angle will be equal to angle EAD. So that means these two sides are equal, these two angles are equal. So now angle ADE is equal to angle ADE is equal to angle DEF because of corresponding part CPCT, and you know that because DF is parallel to AE, angle FDE is equal to angle DEA. These are alternate interior angles. So now if you add these two, angle ADE plus angle FDE, you will get this angle, whole angle D, and here you will get angle DEF plus angle DEA, that is this angle. So if you add these two, you can say that angle D will be equal to angle E. So this is another important conclusion. That means you are having a quadrilateral in which DF is equal to AE, DF is parallel to AE, FE is equal to DA, angle DF E, that is angle F is equal to angle EAD, and because ADE is equal to DEF, we can say that AD is parallel to FE. That means opposite sides are equal and parallel. Opposite angles are equal. That means AEFD is a parallelogram. So here parallelogram
you are having A, B, C, D, and BD is the bisector of the angles at vertex B and D. That is, you can say that ADB is equal to angle ADB is equal to angle BDC, and ABD is equal to angle DBC. So these two angles, they are equal. You have to prove that this ABCD is a rhombus. So how you can do? Because the angle at vertex D is being bisected, that means these two angles are equal. Similarly, here these two angles are equal. Because this is a parallelogram, CD is parallel to AB. This means angle CDB, this angle, will be equal to angle ABD, this angle. But angle ABD is equal to angle DBC. This angle is equal to this angle. It means that these two angles are equal. Combining these two, you can say that angle CDB is equal to angle DBC. This means triangle DBC is isosceles triangle. This means these two sides are equal to each other. Similarly, you can prove for this triangle. Angle ADB is isosceles triangle. If it is isosceles, it means that AD is equal to AB. So, isosceles. This means that CD is equal to BC. You know that CD is equal to AB, opposite side of parallelogram are equal. So this will be equal to AB. You know that BC is equal to DA, opposite side of the parallelogram. So this will be equal to So now we can join the vertex A and C. Triangle ABO and triangle BOC. We can say that AB is equal to BC. So this sides are equal, this side is common, and diagonals are bisecting each other because ABCD is a parallelogram. This means that triangle ABO is congruent to triangle BOC by SSS congruency rule. Angle But angle AOB plus angle BOC is equal to 180 degree. This means you can say that so these angles will be 90 degree. Similarly, you can prove that triangle AOD will be congruent to triangle COD by SSS rule. And similarly, you can prove that these angles will also be equal to 90 degree. That means you can say that and you know that being a parallelogram, AO is equal to OC and DO is equal to OB. Now, triangle AOD is congruent to triangle AOB. This is also by SSS. Similarly, now read what is written. All the sides of a quadrilateral are equal. Diagonals are perpendicular bisectors of each other. Diagonals are bisecting the angles at each of the vertex. This clearly shows that ABCD is a rhombus. So now here, ABCD is a parallelogram and AE is equal to EF is equal to FC. AE is equal to EF is equal to FC. We have to prove that DE is parallel to FB, this line, and DE is equal to FB, and that DE FB will form a parallelogram. So how we can do? First, we will consider the triangle CED and triangle AFB. Because it's a parallelogram, you can say that angle DCE will be equal to angle BAF. You know that AE is equal to EF is equal to FC. You can say that if you assume that each segment is 1 unit, so this will be 2 units. Similarly, this will also be 2 units. So you can say that CE is equal to AF. That means side angle side congruency. So these two triangles are congruent by SAS rule. This means that angle CED will be equal to BFA. Now, if you extend this line, you can see that CA is a transversal and these two angles are alternate interior angles. Hence, you can say that DE is parallel to FB. Another important point is that in these two triangles, you can say that corresponding parts of congruent triangle, side DE will be equal to side FB. So this is another important conclusion. Now we have to prove that DEFB is a parallelogram. So we will join D, E, F and B, E, F. You know that D is equal to FB. And angle DEF is equal to angle EFB. These two angles are equal. And EF is equal to EF. That means these two triangles by SAS, they are congruent. They are congruent by if these two triangles are congruent, then we can say that DF is equal to BE, corresponding part of congruent triangle. This means DF will be equal to these two sides are equal, these two sides are equal. That means in a triangle in the quadrilateral BEFD, we have proved that DE is equal to FB, DE is parallel to FB and DF is equal to BE and these two triangles are congruent. So you can say that angle D is equal to angle B. This is also by corresponding part of congruent triangles. You can say that angle B is equal to angle D. DE is equal to FB, DE is parallel to FB, angle DEF is equal to angle BFE, and we can say that because these two triangles are congruent, that means you can say that angle DEF will be equal to angle DFE. If you add these two, then DEF plus BEF, that means you want to say angle E. If you add BFE and DFE, if you add, you will get this angle. Angle F. DF is equal to EB because these two triangles are congruent. And angle DFE is equal to angle FEB. This means that DF is parallel to EB. So angle B is equal to angle D, DE equal to FB, DE is parallel to FB, E is equal to F, DF is equal to EB and DF is parallel to EB. Opposite sides are equal and parallel and opposite angles are equal. This means that DEBF is a parallelogram. So here ABCD is a parallelogram. AP bisects angle A, BQ bisects angle B. You have to prove that AQ is equal to BP. PQ is equal to CD, let us join PQ, and ABPQ, ABPQ is a parallelogram. So now, since ABCD is a parallelogram, you can see that BC, that means you can write angle BPA will be equal to angle PAQ. These two angles, they are alternate interior angles. Parallel line, intersect, parallel line. And this is given to us. Because PA is the bisector. That means you can say from these two angles, these two angles will be equal. If these two angles are equal, this means that triangle ABP is isosceles triangle. These two angles are equal. This means you can say that AB is equal to BP. Similarly, you can say that AD and BC are parallel. So this angle will be equal to this angle. Angle AQB will be equal to angle QBP. That is, alternate interior angles. But angle QBP is equal to angle QBA, because BQ is bisector of angle at B. This means you can conclude that angle AQB is equal to angle QBA. This means that triangle QAB is isosceles. This means that QAB is isosceles. This means that AB is equal to QA. Or combining these two, you can say that BP is equal to QA. So here you can see we have proved that AQ is equal to BP. Now we have to prove that PQ is equal to CD. So what we can do is, we can consider triangle ABQ and triangle PQB. These two triangles, you can see that AQ is equal to BP as we have proved earlier. Next is, you can see that the angle AQB is equal to angle PBQ, because AD is parallel to BC. So that means this angle will be equal. Alternate interior angles. And this means triangle ABQ is congruent to triangle PQB by side angle side congruency. This means you can say that QP will be equal to AB. These two sides will be equal. Corresponding part of congruent triangle. But you know that ABCD is a parallelogram. So AB is equal to CD. Combining these two, you can say that PQ is equal to CD. This we have. Next, we have to prove that ABPQ is a parallelogram. So as we know that these two triangles are congruent, we can say that angle A will be equal to angle P. Now you know that angle QAP, this angle, this is equal to angle BPA, because these two sides are parallel. So these are alternate interior angles. If you subtract second equation from first equation, you will get angle A minus angle QAP. Angle A minus angle QAP, this will be equal to angle P minus angle BPA. If you solve this, angle A minus angle QAP, you will get angle BAP, this angle BAP will be equal to angle QPA. This means that you can say that QP is parallel to AB, because angle BAP is equal to angle QPA. So these two angles are alternate interior angles. Hence you can say that QP is parallel to AB. So now let us look at the important conclusions regarding this quadrilateral ABPQ. We can say that in quadrilateral ABPQ, BP is equal to AQ, BP is parallel to AQ, and then QP is equal to AB, QP is parallel to AB, and angle A is equal to angle P, and here you can see angle AQB is equal to angle ABQ. These two angles are equal because this is an isosceles triangle. Similarly, this is also isosceles triangle. So these two angles are also equal. Hence, you can say that if you add, you will find angle Q is equal to angle B. So opposite side are equal and parallel. Opposite side equal and parallel. Opposite angles are equal. This means that ABPQ is a parallelogram. So here ABCD is a parallelogram. We have to prove that AB is equal to 2 times BC. Because ABCD is a parallelogram, opposite side will be equal. AB is equal to CD, and CD is equal to, you can see from the figure, DE plus EC. Now you can see that angle ABE will be equal to angle CEB. These angles are alternate interior angles because AB is parallel to CD. You can say that ABE is equal to CEB. But ABE is equal to CDE, given this is indicated in the figure. So this angle is equal to this angle, but this angle is equal to this angle. So this means you can conclude that angle CEB will be equal to angle CBE. In other words, you can say that angle CEB is isosceles. You can say that EC is equal to BC. So here, instead of EC, you can write BC like this. Similarly, angle EAB is equal to angle AED. These two angles are alternate interior angles. And you know that angle EAB is equal to angle EAD. So you can say that this angle is equal to this angle, but this angle is equal to this angle. And these two angles are equal. Angle AED is equal to angle EAD. Or you can say that triangle EDA is isosceles. EDA is isosceles. That means ED is equal to DA. So instead of ED, you can write here DA. Like this. DA is equal to BC. DA is equal to BC. Is there opposite side of a parallelogram? So instead of DA, you can write here BC. This means that AB is equal to 2 times BC. Hence, root.